अजात शत्रु, ए स्टोरी फ्रॉम बुद्धाज लाइफ। बिफोर द टाइम ऑफ बुद्धा, बिंबिसार एस्टैब्लिश्ड ए पावरफुल किंगडम इन इंडिया कॉल्ड मगध। दिस वॉज लोकेटेड ऑन द ईस्टर्न पार्ट ऑफ इंडिया। बिंबिसार वॉज ए पायस मैन। पीपुल ट्रस्टेड हिम एंड ही लिसन्ड टू हिज सब्जेक्ट्स। His son Ajatashatru was unlike his father. He killed his father and brought back monarchy to rule Magadha. After spending years of war and bloodshed, Ajatashatru became unhappy and haunted. He came to Buddha for his salvation. Buddha accepted him as his disciple. And Ajatashatru rested in peace. Prasenji, the king of Koshal, a small neighboring kingdom of Magadha, was a brave and a just ruler. People loved him. He believed in people's rule and deeply respected Buddha and followed his principles. Prasenjit was very upset when he heard that Ajatashatru has killed his father, Bimbisar, the ruler of Magadha, and ruled his kingdom by monarchy. Prasenjit declared to his ministry, Bimbisar has been murdered by his son Ajatashatru. We had good relation with Magadha, as its ruler was friendly to us. Now we'll sever all relations with Magadha, and the man who killed Bimbisar will be our enemy. Hearing this announcement, Ajatashatru, as expected, raged a war against Koshal. Koshal was a small kingdom and could not resist the attack of Ajatashatru. The army of Koshal retreated and took shelter in the capital. The commander came to Prasenjit and reported their withdrawal. Prasenjit was old, but a brave king. He said to the commander, I have to go myself. Ajatashatru must be stopped before he does more harm. He went to the battlefield and challenged Ajatashatru. Shame on you to kill your unarmed father. I am old, but I will defend myself. If you have the guts, try to kill me. Ajatashatru was outraged and charged with his elephant towards Prasenjit. Prasenjit stayed calm and at the right moment killed the elephant on which Ajatashatru was taking the ride. Ajatashatru jumped out and ran towards Prasenjit with his piercing sword. Prasenjit also came down to the ground and stood face to face with Ajatashatru. You, the disgraceful son, father killer, come forward and face your enemy squarely. Ajatashatru, with the guilt feeling of executing his father in the prison, lost control. He swung his sword at Prasenjit, but in a moment he lost his sword. He was now at the mercy of Prasenjit. Ajatashatru shouted, kill me, kill me. I am a sinner. I want to die. Prasenjit shouted back, no, I will let you go and repent for rest of your life. Ajatashatru said, I realized my father's love when I got my own son and repented. it was too late to take back my execution orders. Would you listen to this old man? Asked Prasenjit. You can only get over your sense of guilt if you wish for peace and not for war. Wish for life and not for death. Dejected Ajatashatru came back to Magad. He was no more interested in earthly pleasures. He tried to talk to saints and monks, but that too did not bring peace in his troubled mind. As he was unable to get over his sense of guilt of executing his innocent father, he planned to stay engaged in war again. But victory no longer excited him. This was the only way he knew to override his depression at the cost of numerous lives. He was jealous of Lijbi. It was a prosperous kingdom with people's rule, unlike Magad that believed in monarchy. People of Lijbi were strongly united and were always ready to dedicate their lives for their country. Ajatashatru was aware of the strength of Lijbi, and for him it was a challenge to win. He built a new strong capital named Pataliputra and began to make a long-term plan to win over Lijbi. He also invented a new war machinery to fight on a large scale and kept it a secret. This kept him busy for 2 years. The chief of Lijbi called his men and said, Ajatashatru is preparing himself for a long time to attack us. If we want to save our democratic system of government, we have to fight against him with all our might, or else he will run over us. Remember, war is his way of life, and he is ruthless. When Ajatashatru attacked Lijbi, people tried to resist him and laid their lives for the defense of Lijbi. But victory went to Ajatashatru after a heavy bloodshed. This long-awaited victory, however, did not bring joy to Ajatashatru. He was in constant melancholy. He went into deep depression and became mentally sick. At the end, Ajatashatru called Jivak, his medical advisor and friend. Jivak said, Ajatashatru, your illness will not be cured by medicine. You have to find out peace within yourself. You had been constantly engaged in war since your father's death to fight your own conscience. The time has come that you seek help from Lord Buddha. He is the only one who can help you in your mental state. Ajatashatru remembered Prasenjit. The old man was right. I cannot have a long-lasting peace as long as I am engaged in war. Jivak asked Ajatashatru to accompany him to Lord Buddha, who was then stationed at Amrai, located on the border of Magad. Ajatashatru was desperate. He accompanied Jivak. When Ajatashatru faced Buddha, he was charmed by his glowing personality. Ajatashatru spontaneously begged in his mind, O Lord, bail me out of my misery. Then he ran towards Lord Buddha and fell on his feet. Buddha blessed him. To him, repentance burns away the sin and peace prevails in the mind of the sinner. Finally, restless Ajatashatru felt his long-cherished peace of mind and became a devoted disciple of Lord Buddha.